Lou, bro.
You hit that bitch.
Hey, all we needed was the motherfucking striker anyway.
I got the cash, man. We all set to go for tomorrow for sure.
I really ain't fucking with them niggas. I ain't gonna lie.
Word?
Yeah,
bro. Them niggas ain't my niggas anyway.
You ain't your niggas and you ain't fucking with them. Then we can put them niggas on the float. Say no more then. It's on.
Joey, wake up. Joey, you going to church with me? This is what my son is doing? Just run the streets? You're going to end up in jail or dead. Joey, get up!
But there is one place of discomfort that compares to none other. It's a place the Bible calls hell. It talks about hell. It is described as a flame of fire, a furnace of fire, a lake of fire, place of sorrows, place of torment, place of weeping. It is a place where the worm dieth not. Death is eternal. The devil and his demons, the wicked, those that live contrary to the will of God. It is a real place. It is a place of eternal torment where pain and suffering has no end. It is a place where people will be gathered and cast into outer darkness.
And he said, I will say to you, depart from me, ye that work iniquity. I never knew you.
Took your ass forever.
I'm here, ain't I?
Talking about you got down on them niggas last night, man. What's going on?
I don't know what you talking about, bro.
Nah, niggas don't know what I'm talking about. That be your problem right there, man. The whole hood done already told me, man.
Hey, I ain't nigga trouble. Shit a nigga do, bro. They ain't got shit to do with me.
Man, I understand that you might not have been there, but them niggas know where that shit came from. You already know how this shit go. I'm just telling you to let you know the whole hood talking.
Hey, I ain't worried about no nigga, bro. The niggas had to get in the blood with you, bro.
I mean, that sound cool and all, but like I told you, you making this cheese and you ain't even gonna be around here to spend it. Shit ain't even worth it at the end of the day.
Nah, I am.
Yeah, you heard what I said. I'm out.
What's
up, bro? Hey, bro.
Y'all ever catch up with them hoe ass niggas that ride drunk?
Fuck!
Oh, bro.
Right.
What's up with
you?
Bro, got the
bro.
What?
What?
Oh, yeah,
we
need that.
I
got you,
bro. You
call him right now.
Jeez, bro.
Yeah,
right now,
that,
bro.
Fuck up, bro. Real. Hell
yeah. Hey, man. I don't know. Why the fuck you be wanting to meet at the court? Your ass can't even fucking move. Did you get your bitch pregnant? Fuck wrong with you, man?
Nigga, why the fuck your ass always playing, dog? And why the fuck you let them dirty ass niggas ride my people?
Bro, I don't know what you're talking about.
Nah, you know what I'm talking about. Nigga, that's your problem. You never know shit about how to motherfucking play, dog. Might as well keep this little shit. I don't need that.
What else you on? You on that?
I'm tired of saving y'all little niggas, man. Your ass gonna learn. It look like it's gonna be the hard way. Hello? Yeah, I know where that nigga be at.
Kid right here for sure.
Hell yeah, that's his shit.
He look like dog stay with this OG gang. I ain't gonna lie.
So nigga?
How y'all trying to play it then? Shit, I'm going in front of that bitch.
Best say less. Wake the fuck up, snap out of that shit, man.
A woman killed after an early morning shooting on Detroit's east side. Investigators are still there piecing together what happened.
A woman was fatally shot by a man. The circumstances are being investigated. If you have any information, you're asked to call Detroit police or 1-800-SPEAK-UP. Reporting live on the east side of Detroit, I'm Megan Woods.
Thank you.
Do you know what it takes for a seed to become a flower? First, a seed must be buried underground. Then a storm comes and rains down on it. Only then for it to sprout up and become a flower again. The only way you'll find your purpose in life is if you water your seed.
Shot in the head, you change her hair color.
What, you don't like it or something?
Yeah.
How you feel? I really thought I lost you, Joey.
I ain't going nowhere.
You need to make better decisions. You need to be smarter. You got a lot to lose. You can stay here for a while, you know, to get back on your feet and stuff. Where did you get this artwork from, Joey?
Painter.
No, you didn't. This is fucking fire.
Yeah, painting them.
And you never thought to take art serious?
Man, ain't an opportunity to come around for a nigga like me to kind of paint. I'm not about to be fucking with paint.
Do you not see this?
Man, I'm not fucking with no painting, man.
The fact that you don't believe in yourself, that shit is irritating.
What's up, man? I'd already apologized a thousand times. Never thought I'd get to this. But I did come with some good news that I got an opportunity to showcase my art out in Paris.
with this like huge art gallery. So, of course, that's good. I know you always wanted me to be a painter, so I'm trying to really follow up with that. Stay in the straight and narrow, of course, stay out the streets. And I even got some greater news. You're gonna be a grandma. You know, he was always talking about trying to be a grandma, or wanting to be a grandma, or whatever. So, you're gonna be a grandma. But I miss you, Ma. I love you.
Jess, you got a feel for the neighbors in that area, fearing for their safety and their lives.
Some 40 shots fired, just unbelievable.
And there was over 36 shots that were fired.
Signs of that, some three dozen bullets duct taped over.
That displayed to myself watching the video, carelessness for the community itself. Two of the individuals are captured on video shooting weapons.
It appears whoever was in the car fired first.
I believe there was an exchange, a verbal altercation with the vehicle that led to the escalation of the use of firearms.
In custody, facing some serious charges.
It's not an instance where you can take pulling that trigger back.
I never ended up going with him that night. I kind of feel like God gave me a second chance. And I honestly don't even know why he would give me a second chance. But I do feel like it's up to me to make sure I take advantage of it. I got a kid on the way that's gonna be dependent on me. And I feel like it's my job to make sure they don't have to go through anything I had to go through. But for now, only time will tell.